If you've ever tried using an Arduino and a voltage divider network to read battery voltage, I'm sure you've noticed that the readings are inaccurate when VCC begins to fall as the battery discharges. In today's video, we will take a look at how to solve this problem and read battery voltage accurately from when the battery is fully charged up until when it's fully discharged. Come along. So according to this documentation here, the default analog reference voltage of 5 volts boards is 5 volts and that of 3.3 volt boards is 3.3 volts. In our case, we are using a 3.3 volts 8 megahertz Arduino Pro Mini. So it's safe to say that the VCC voltage is what is used as analog reference voltage for these boards. From here, it's easy to see why the changing VCC voltage leads to inaccurate reading of the battery on the analog pin. We can actually visualize this problem by using the code example under File, Examples, Basics, and Read Analog Voltage. Down here, we will change this 5 volts reference to 3.3 volts because we are using a 3.3 volts board. And then we proceed to upload this sketch. Using this wiring, we are going to replace the battery here with this power supply to simulate a rising and falling battery level. Let's set a lower current in order not to damage our Arduino. Because we are using two 10 kilo ohm resistors, the analog pin would experience half of the voltage that we initially sent in. So we have to multiply the output that is read by the analog pin by 2 to restore that half that was taken off by the resistors. So over here in the code, we are just going to multiply the analog voltage here by 2 and then upload this. So now let's begin to simulate a falling battery voltage and see the corresponding values in the serial monitor. So we'll turn this on and then adjust this way. And as this falls, we can also see the serial monitor values correspond to the falling values here. So we can see here that our battery level is at 3.4, but our serial monitor says the battery is at 3.6. This is because the reference voltage that was used in the code is 3.3 volts. And that 3.3 volts has long changed, but because it is not being tracked, it's not referencing the actual voltage at VCC. And because of that, we are seeing a different voltage here as well. If we go further down, we can see that this does not change by much because it's still using the 3.3 volts. However, if we should climb back up, we can see that at some point, the battery voltage becomes accurate once again in the serial monitor. And this happens as soon as the VCC returns back to 3.3 volts. If you are new here, kindly subscribe to stay in touch on how to design and build more cool stuff. In order to track VCC, I'm using this Arduino VCC resource over here on GitHub, and it was created by someone called Evu. Sorry if I butchered your name. So I took these resources and made a few modifications. The first thing that we have to note is to use two resistor values that are equal. In my case, I used two 10 kilo ohm resistors, and this makes calculation a lot easier. Also, I only need to multiply whatever analog pin A0 reads by 2 to get the original value that came in. If you decide to use values other than the 10K I've used here, make sure to use higher values because lesser values will lead to a higher flow of current to ground, which would end up discharging the battery a lot faster. Also, do well to add the vcc.h and vcc.cpp files to your Arduino libraries. I would include links to these resources in the video description below. So over here, we have the libraries being included. And the next thing is to specify the VCC minimum, which is 0.0 volts. The VCC max here indicates the maximum voltage output of the regulator. And we need to use a multimeter to measure this. So we can see here the voltage is 3.303. So we would go ahead and indicate that in the code. Now that we've been able to confirm 3.303 volts as the regulator output voltage, we now have to calibrate the Arduino to also output the same value. And we can do that by tweaking this figure over here. The next thing is to specify which voltage should be considered a dead battery or a completely discharged battery. So in our case, we've specified 2.9 volts as that. And then a full charge battery should be at 4.2 volts. So we've indicated that as well over here. We are using analog pin A0 for reading the battery voltage and outputting data to the serial monitor at a baud rate of 9600. Next, we are collecting 100 VCC voltage samples and averaging it to find a more accurate and stable VCC voltage. And then that VCC voltage is outputted here. You can upload this code and keep tweaking this value till your output here at VCC is equal to what you measured using your multimeter. Here we collect 100 battery voltage samples using the VCC we calculated or found earlier as reference. And you can see here we multiply by 2 once again. We calculate the average battery voltage and output it to 2 decimal places over here. Finally, we calculate the percentage of the battery with regards to what we found here. One other thing to note is when battery percentage is calculated, it's not calculated using 0 volt and 4.2 volts, but rather when the battery is said to be at its lowest and when the battery is said to be at its maximum or full charge state. So in our case, it's 2.9 to 4.2. So 0 to 100 between 2.9 to 4.2. So now let's go ahead and upload this code. And we can see in our serial monitor that it says VCC is 3.04, but our VCC is not 3.04, it's 3.03. So we will go ahead and tweak this figure a little bit till we have 3.303. Okay, so now we have 3.303 and we can see that it says our battery is at 4.21 volts at 100%. And if we look here on our screen, we can see 4.21 volts. Let's now go ahead and tweak this value to see if our Arduino can now read battery voltage up until the battery is supposed to be dead. So when we start decreasing this, we can see in the serial monitor, the percentage has started to drop as well, but VCC remains the same. And we can see up to 3 volts, it is still reading accurate values. So let's drop this further below the value we've set. So we set 2.9, so let's keep dropping. And so at this point, 2.9, the battery should be dead, right? And the board should be off because the regulator's output is not going to be enough to keep the board awake. So we can see here in the serial monitor, when the voltage falls all the way to when VCC is 2.7, the board goes off. And if we should come back up slowly, and when we come back up slowly, we realize that when the voltage, supply voltage is back at 3 volts, the serial monitor begins to respond again, which indicates 10% battery left. So now I'm going to connect this battery back to the circuit and read its voltage. So measuring our battery voltage with this multimeter, we can see 4.107, which is approximately 4.11. And in the serial monitor here, we can see 4.12, which corresponds to 93.88%. So that is that. If you don't mind spending some extra cash and the shipping time, you can order one of these full gauge modules that you can connect to your Arduino via I2C and read your battery voltage level. I will be making a separate video for this. Please subscribe for when that video comes out. If you've learned something new here today, kindly give us a thumbs up to show your support for this channel and subscribe to stay in touch on how to design and build more cool stuff. See you around.